Like in my free time, I watch a lot of reality shows, especially Norwegians and also the Love Island, but it was normally the Love Island UK. I think it originally came from the UK and it's like super big, maybe the biggest reality show there. And I watched like all the seasons, and then it came to Norway. And then I just sent the application, and then they called me and wanted me for interview. And then I went to the interview, and I went to interview with the TV channel and stuff, and they wanted me to be there. And I'm very spontaneous, and I like to do like adventurous stuff. So I just went there. I thought it would be nice. It was in Argentina. It was hot weather, and yeah. So I really enjoyed it. I did some interviews with TV2, the TV host for the show, and before I checked in to the villa, and then I told them like at that time I was 4 times Norwegian champ, and I played at Worlds and stuff, and yeah, just so they could make an article before I checked in. For the other participants, I didn't tell them that I was an esports player. It actually came. Because Love Island is a live show, so you got the questions from the outside, from the people watching, and they asked me how it is to be like Norwegian champion at League of Legends, blah blah blah. All of a sudden, everyone was like, "Whoa, are you a professional esports player?" And they got like kind of hyped, I would say. And then it was easier for me to like talk about it because I don't just randomly go to people and say, "Hey, I'm 6 times Norwegian champ. I played in Worlds." Like you need to have a normal conversation about it, or like, so you're just not bragging about it. Yeah, like after this show, and after people realizing that I was an esport player, then it was easier for me as well to talk about it and like tell people more about what this is. Then I posted more about it on my social medias, especially from the like not Twitter, but on Instagram and stuff, where normal people follow me. And then they started to support me and wrote me nice messages, and we made a documentary as well that's coming out very soon about being a reality participant and also a esports, and try to normalize the stereotype of gamers. So I'm looking forward to that, and so the feedback is just good. I would say I was pretty lucky getting into Worlds because it was like the early days of League of Legends. It was season 4. I think the level was like lower than now. There's a lot of more talents out there now than compared to when I was young. I mean, we went in there as a wildcard team, and we took it as an experience. Like we didn't expect to win or like get out of groups. We just wanted to play the best teams, learn as much as we can, and take it with us the next split. I mean, we had some close games, I guess some of them, but we got kind of stomped anyway. But we played the world champions that year, Samsung Galaxy, Samsung White, and then yeah, it was just a great experience. You're going into Worlds like a fanboy-ish, and you play like the best players you watched. I mean, compared to like 10 years ago, like early days of esport, I think it's evolving in the right way. You get, as you said, all the regions and all the leagues you can play in, and you can actually make a like career out of it. Compared to before, you needed to be in the like top spots to make it worth, kinda. Because if you just played for fun or like in the lower regions, no one offered salary. You didn't have much to take from the game. But I still think there is like this. If you talk to a person that is not into esport, then he would automatically think this way, where the stereotypes are like bad people sitting inside in the dark room, eating junk food, and just playing games with no purpose. But now, persons or the community, and even the people who are not so into esport, I think they are understanding a bit more, because now you can see it like everywhere. You see it on the television, you see it on streams, you see a lot of people talking about esport, and it's actually becoming a big thing. First of all, you need to work hard because I think hard work beats talents, and you have to sacrifice social life-ish friends or like things that happen in real life. It sounds really bad that you have to sacrifice it, but it will like if you want your gold, you have to like work for it, and you have to stop doing going to parties or like stop doing other things that kind of ruins your way to your goal. So I just think as long as you're dedicated, work hard and put a lot of time into it and stay focused, then I think it would help you a lot on the road to your goal.